ARC campus when we could host this event. This event, as you know, is sponsored by the Women for Curlies Ridge College, which is our auxiliary. We're going to tell you more about that in just a minute. But as we begin tonight, we just had a meal. I hope it was a lovely meal for you. Our staff here on campus fixed this meal. Was the meal any good? Can you let us know? All right. Teresa Mitchell and her staff fixed the meal for us tonight. As we begin tonight, we want to pause for a moment, if you will, and we want to go to God together in prayer, thanking Him for the food and the blessings of the day. And Richard Johnson is going to lead us in prayer.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for this beautiful day and for all of the friends that have come to Curlies Ridge College tonight. And thank you for their safe trip and their time for being here and for the college and all those that thought many years ago to start this needed ministry. And we're grateful for the opportunity to help young people, to help them to grow into adults that want to serve you and have families that will be dedicated to you. Thank you for that opportunity. Bless us in our work. Thank you for the wisdom of our board. And thank you for this evening. Help us to have a great time and bless the food and nourishment of our bodies. In Christ we pray. Amen.
As mentioned earlier, this is a fundraising event for Women for Curlies Ridge College. If you didn't know it was a fundraising event when you came, well, let me tell you now, it's a fundraising event. That's why we ladies host this dinner, so they can raise money. Women for Curlies Ridge College started back in 1970, but they have sponsored 23 of these events and a number of other events on campus so they can raise money to do things on the college campus and to support the work of the college. After this event tonight, their amount that they would have given to the college through events like this exceeds $400,000 over the years. So give the Women for Curlies Ridge College a hand. Take just a minute. It's a very special group of ladies that just work hard on events like this. Can I get the women from Curlies Ridge College to stand? We should probably have about 20 or 25 here tonight if we get them to stand. Alright, give them a hand as well. We know we came for a wonderful show tonight. We won't take too long in our introductory comments tonight, but just a couple of things that we want to let you know about. One is the Spirit of America that's coming up on April the 18th. There's a flyer on your table concerning Colin Ray. He's going to be here with us. He's a famous country artist, and he's going to be here with us on April the 18th. We just got the firm contract from him yesterday. We're already selling tickets today, so we encourage you to go ahead and get your tickets for Spirit of America. It'll be on April 18th right here in this same facility. We also want to mention to you that we have a token of appreciation for everyone here tonight. There's a 2014 calendar. They're on the desk as you leave. You pick those up. There's also a table set up with information about the college, anything that you might want to know. And there'll be college representatives around in the vestibule area, the lobby area as we conclude tonight. We want you to remember the country store that is back here to my right in the corner. There's all sorts of goodies there that you can buy. And the ladies have worked very hard to prepare those things, and they've already sold a number of things. But there's still yet a number yet remaining there. Tonight we want to take just a few minutes to make a little bit of a special presentation. We don't often stop at this event to make presentations. We kind of make those at different times, but we have a special presentation to make tonight. And I need Bill Penguin to join me on the stage. This event over the years, this is a tremendous event for our staff to put together. And over the last number of years, how many years have you worked here?
9 years.
Bill's been here 9 years, and in these 9 years, he's been involved in this event, plus all of our maintenance duties on campus as well. He is our maintenance manager in charge of facilities, and not in charge of facilities, in charge of grounds and vehicles. Have another man that does that. But Bill has been very instrumental in the things that he's done for us. During this past sleet storm that we had this winter, our students have really noticed the exceptional effort that Bill has put forward to keep our campus clear and to do those other sorts of things that are around the campus. He has caught the attention of our students in doing this, as well as faculty and staff. And it's a big deal around this campus to have the yearbook dedicated to you. And this coming 2013-14 Crowley's Ridge College yearbook is going to be dedicated to Bill Painter. And here's what the students wrote. It said, "Neither rain nor snow nor sleet nor hail shall keep the postman from his appointed duties. This popular saying about the U.S. Postal Service can be easily be used here at Crowley's Ridge College campus concerning our own Bill Painter, especially this year. The winter of 2013-14 continually pelted us with freezing rain, lots of sleet, and a little snow. Bill Painter, campus and transportation maintenance manager, became a fixture on our campus roadways, plowing and scraping ice. The last winter storm in early March dumped over 4 inches of sleet with a little snow on top. He spent days on the tractor trying to make the campus roads passable. When he's not on the tractor in the winter, he can be found mowing in the spring and summer, washing the buses, making sure all the vehicles are full of fuel for the many trips our teams and organizations take during the year. You'll also see him up for the special activities held in the gym throughout the year. Homecoming, Barnyard Bash, Lectureship, and Spirit of America, to name just a few. Need the books hauled to the book depot after the semester ends? Bill's there. Need something picked up downtown? Bill will do it. Bill Painter is just an all-around good guy, ready to help the staff, students, or anyone else who needs him, and he does it with a smile, and usually a joke or two, and his famous statement, there's never a dull moment." The 2013-14 Heritage Yearbook is proudly dedicated to Bill Painter. This is special because it's our students that make this selection to be able to be congratulated.
Oh, Bill, by the way, you're going to be leading the Star Spangled Banner.
Well, without further ado, we're here for a show tonight, so at this time, will you welcome Gary Cremings.
Thank you very much. I got to say this about Bill here, and in just a moment, we're going to stand, we're going to do the Star Spangled Banner, but I bet you on a week like this week and a week like last week, Bill is a lot like a cannibal. He is fed up on people because everybody says, "Bill." And I mean, there's always something for Bill to do, but Bill does it. And Bill and Lance Johns work themselves tirelessly to make this thing happen, along with the women of WCRC. But I'll talk about that here in just a minute when I get my base on. I tell you what, let's all stand. We have a flag on the south wall. And what I would like for us all to do is sing the Star Spangled Banner.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?"
Thank you very much. You may be seated. Bill, are you going to turn out the house lights? These folks look better in the dark, I can tell you that right now. Folks, if this show had happened last Friday night, it would have looked a lot different. By postponing a week, we lost about half our singers, part of the band. Because of weather and because of miscellaneous other things that just couldn't be helped. But regardless, we would have started the show just like this. Kathy Rowe has been a humongous help around this place for a long time. This backdrop, she painted that thing. She comes in and puts the animals on it every year. I don't know, I didn't know this until tonight, but the rooster winds up in a different place every year. But she also decorates these side stage. She does a whole lot of neat things, and we really appreciate her, as well as Sheila and Kathy Jarrett.
But she makes some cookies for the rehearsal
too. Yes, she does! We're supposed to dedicate this song to Mr. Joe Underwood. I've never met you before in my life, but this song's for you, Joe. All right? He told me to jump up and down 3 or 4 times on the stage, but I said, I'm not going that far. The stage wouldn't hold it, so.
There's a tree out in the backyard that never has been broken by the wind, and the reason it's still standing, it was strong enough to be. Thank you.
Kathy Sheila Bailey. Now, as it turns out, Kathy Jarrett is hanging around because her husband happens to be the next singer who is going to accompany her. How about a big hand for Mr. John Jarrett? For a minute, I thought she was married to Billy Moore because he was doubling up his kids.
I didn't know.
Hey, and by the way, I don't know if y'all know this or not, but I take personal responsibility for this marriage. I went to a hot dog roast and a wedding erupted.
True. He done a good job.
Put you in holy deadlock, didn't I? Anybody who can take melody, words, rhythm and all that goes with it and the heart and all that kind of stuff puts together and comes out sounding like a song. And he has written one now that I really, really like. How about a big hand for Billy Moore?
Polar bear will be in the zoo. So in other words, nothing changed.
That's right. That's right. That is changed. Well, what have you been doing this winter, Grandpa?
Well, I went up to see my cousin Billy Bob. You know, his dad died last week.
Oh, he did.
Yeah, but he, you know, had a long life and everything. He told Billy Bob, though, his secret to long life was to take a little pinch of gunpowder and put it on his oatmeal every morning.
Gunpowder on your oatmeal?
Yeah, but he lived a long time. When he died, he left like 15 children, about 30 grandchildren. I think there's like 45 great-grandchildren, 32 great-great-grandchildren, and a 15-foot hole in the ground where the crematorium used to be.
Well, I'll tell you what I've been doing while you've been down there.
What?
We had a class reunion. Oh, we had more fun. Yeah, you know, everybody's overweight and nobody has good hair anymore, but it was just a lot of fun, you know. Well, on our 10th year reunion, we remembered that we went to Charlie's Restaurant because it was the best place in town to go eat, you know.
Oh, yeah.
It is. Then on our 20th, we went to Charlie's Restaurant because they have a really good seafood buffet.
They do.
And then on 30th, we remembered that we went to Charlie's Restaurant because it has a really good dessert bar.
It does.
And then on our 40th, we remembered that we went to Charlie's Restaurant because it's nice and quiet there, you know, and it's smoke-free.
Good atmosphere.
Yeah. Then on our 50th, we remembered that we went to Charlie's Restaurant, you know, because it's handicap accessible and it even has an elevator and everything. And on our 60th anniversary, we went to Charlie's Restaurant because we remembered that we'd never been there before.
Did you find a fellow to work with at this reunion? Oh, I did.
But first, I have to tell you about a kiss I got right here tonight.
Tonight?
Oh, yeah, there's a crowd coming in, you know, and this old fella just grabbed me and kissed me. He said, Minnie, I'm going to kiss you or die trying. Well, you ain't seen his name in the death notices yet, have you? No, he kissed me right here on the back of my neck.
Back of the neck?
Yeah. He didn't know his way around very good, did he?
I guess not.
No, you know, the thing about finding old flames at reunions is that old flames have just gotten older. But I did some reading, you know, on how you should meet up with your old flame at a reunion, you know, what you should do. And it said that you should, you know, pretend that you don't recognize him, you know, kind of make him jealous.
Yeah.
Pretend that you don't recognize him. Who has to pretend? But it also said, you know, that you ought to be mysterious. Don't lay all your cards on the table. You know, you don't have to tell all. You don't have to tell you've been to prison. And it also said to don't lie. And so I decided to not tell that I was a brain surgeon.
Well, go ahead and tell me what happened this reunion.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, I was standing there pondering how much healthy choice ice cream I could eat before it's no longer a healthy choice. And there he was.
Who?
Well, the man of my dreams 50 years ago. Yeah. Well, I did hardly recognize him because he was all disheveled, his clothes, his hair was a mess and everything. And I said, what have you been doing? And he said, well, I walked over here and Farmer Gus lets you cross through his fields for free, but apparently the bull charges. Well, he's not much smarter than he was way back then, you know. I tell you, Grandpa, we're a whole lot smarter than this younger generation coming up. Because
so.
We all got through school without Google or Wikipedia.
I found that old Junior's still pretty smart.
Junior smart?
Yeah. I had a problem the other day. I was going to go to a psychiatrist.
Psychiatrist?
Yeah. Well, I every time I got to med, I thought there was somebody under it.
Oh.
Yeah, wow. And that psychiatrist was going to charge me like $200 a visit to cure me. And
yeah.
Junior cured me for $10.
He did. What did he do?
He told me to put the legs off
a bed. Well, that's a good idea. Well, I'll tell you what, all that food looks so good over there tonight, but I've been on a diet.
Yeah.
So I brought my own food along. Gluten-free, dairy-free, low-carb pizza.
What's
that? That's a slice of tomato.
Oh. No. I mean, you got to seize the moment.
Seize the moment?
Yeah. Think about all those women on the Titanic. Waved off the dessert bar.
That's true. true. Well, I have had a few stomach issues lately, you know, and so my doctor sent me over there to that Mayo Clinic.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I drove all the way up there, and I thought I was lost. I couldn't find it anywhere. Come to find out, they changed the name of it from Mayo Clinic to Balsamic Vinaigrette Clinic. I guess that sounds a whole lot healthier.
One thing, well, I'm glad I'm retired and not out job hunting now. It's just tough out there.
Oh, yeah, really? It's hard to find
a
job.
Yeah, my nephew Homer, he went up to Nashville the other day.
Yeah.
And they said they'd hire him for $5 a day, and then after 5 years, you're working way up to $200 a week. He said, okay, I'll be back in 5 years.
Well, my niece Junebug, she got her a real good job lately.
What's she doing?
Well, she's a cop.
Oh, cop?
Yeah. She stopped this little blonde girl in a real fast red car, you know, speeding and everything. And so she has to show her license.
Yeah.
And so that blonde dug around in her purse, you know, and everything. And she said, well, what does it look like? And Junebug said, well, it's square and it has your picture on it. So she dug around some more, and she came out with a mirror and handed it to Junebug. Junebug looked at it and said, oh, sorry, I didn't know you were a cop.
Well, I got stopped by a real cop the other day.
You did?
Yeah. He pulled me over, and I had a bunch of daggers in my back seat. He said, what are those daggers for? I said, well, I'm a juggler. He said, I don't believe you. I said, well, I'll just show you. So I got out and started throwing them daggers left and right. Car came a whizzing by with the windows rolled down. They said, oh, look at there. Aren't you glad we don't drink? Look what they substituted for a breathalyzer now.
Oh, I'll tell you, Grandpa. Well, you know, with all this, was I talking about crime? I think I was. let me just check here what I was going to talk about.
Rewind.
Yeah, maybe the page is in here somewhere. I think I was going to talk about it. Oh, yeah, because, you know, when unemployment, that's what I was going to say. I was going to talk about
unemployment. That's right. Yeah. That's a good subject.
There's so much unemployment, you know, it always raises the crime rate.
Sure does.
Oh, yeah. So my neighbor got burglarized the other night.
Really?
Oh, she did. And so then that made me worry about my little lock. I didn't think it could keep anybody out. So yeah. I got a brilliant idea. I put a sign on the outside of the door that said, don't come in, Lucille. The snake's loose.
People now.
Oh, boy. You remember Lucille's daughter, Trudy?
Yeah.
Well, Trudy has gone back to college to get her a master's degree in philosophy.
Philosophy?
I said, Trudy, what can you do with a degree like that? And she said, well, I can answer questions about the essence of life and life's existence and all, and do you want fries with that?
How good that is.
I'll tell you. A few years ago, you know, Trudy, she kind of needed to find herself, and so Lucille thought it'd be good for her to go on an adventure. So she sent her off on an adventure, and so she was coming in on the plane, coming back from it, you know.
Yeah.
And so Lucille was there to meet her, and she noticed this man kind of walking beside Trudy, and he had exotic markings all over his body and feathers and carrying a shrunken head, and Trudy introduced him as her new husband.
Oh,
Lucille hollered and said, I told you to marry a rich doctor, a rich doctor.
Oh, boy. I bet that's been something.
Oh, that's been quite a marriage there.
Yeah. My cousin Walter, he's been having some marital problems, too.
Oh,
yeah. Well. So his wife's going to cook him a real nice meal, you know.
Oh, that always helps.
Yeah. She said in the store, get some snails. She'll make you some of that real fancy escargot.
Escargot,
yeah. Anyway, he saw one of his friends down there, and friends said, come on over and watch some wrestling. He goes over and watches a little wrestling, and time gets away from him.
Oh, yeah.
He runs home as fast as he could, and got there right at the front door, and he tripped on the front step, and those snails went all over the front porch. And his wife heard a commotion, and she came out there and said, "You better have a good excuse for being late." So he got down on his hands and knees. He said, "Come on, boys, 5 more feet, we'll be there." And my other cousin, a Homer,
yeah.
Well, he had a near catastrophe the other day while he was out fishing.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
What happened?
He saw this lady out there in deep water just flailing, and so he can't swim, you know. So he called for his friend Chester, who was also fishing that day,
yeah.
And said, "Chester, my wife's about to drown. Can you run out there and save her? I can't swim. I'll give you $100. So Chester dives off in that deep water, and he brings that woman up on shore, and he looks up at Homer to get his money, and Homer goes, "Well, she was going down the third time, I thought it was my wife, but that's my mother-in-law." So old Chester gets his wallet out and says, "Just my luck, how much do I owe you?"
Oh, dear, we better not get started on mother-in-law jokes.
No.
You know, but one of the best things about being mother-in-law, you know, is all those little grandkids you get to enjoy.
Oh,
yeah. Mine were playing the other day out in the field, and one of them Army helicopters came by, and they were practicing, and those paratroopers were jumping out, you know. So one jumped out right there and wanted to scare them little kids to death. They came running to the house. They said, "Grammy, Grammy, come quick. The storks took to dropping them full grown."
My little grandson, Leroy, he's sort of funny, but anyway, the other day he got himself into some trouble.
He did?
Yeah, a traveling salesman came by knocking on the door, and Leroy opened the door, puffing on a big old long cigar.
Oh,
wow.
No.
Yeah, and that salesman sort of shocked him. He said, "Son, is your mother home?" And he said, took that cigar out of his mouth and put some ashes on the carpet, and said, "What do you think?"
I think not. Oh, boy. You know, Grandpa, I'm really excited about this 50th anniversary party we're going to have later.
Me
you
too.
Know, I've always wanted to be quick homecoming queen, you know.
Sure.
So, but, you know, the thing I'm most excited about
is
that I can fit into my dress that I wore when I was 20 years old.
And it fits?
Oh, yeah. With a little adjustment, it just fits like a glove.
That sounds like a problem to me. Shouldn't it fit like a dress?
Well, yeah, but, you know, I hope they have a big old anniversary cake there, because I'm going to have a big piece. I'm going to break this diet.
Don't blame.
I was at the nursing home last week seeing Aunt Bessie, you know?
Yeah.
This man was giving a lecture to them about food, all the food we eat. He said, "All the rubbish that we put in our bodies ought to kill us years ago, you know? Red meat's terrible for you, and all those fizzy drinks just tear up your stomach lining.
That's right.
And all that MSG and Chinese food, and the fruits and vegetables are grown in fertilizer and pesticides and all that, so bad." But he said, "But there's one food that almost everybody here has eaten, and it causes the most grief and suffering of any food. Does anybody know what that might be?" Aunt Bessie raises her hand and said, "Wedding cake."
That's the truth.
Goodness. Grandpa, we better quit this and get ready for the anniversary party.
Listen.
I told you, if you'd have been here last week, you'd have been by yourself, for one thing. But we lost some people, and so because of scheduling and that kind of thing. And so I asked Chase, because Chase Akins, who is our youth and worship minister at Hillcrest, and he had been singing with Joy Becerra and Brady Becerra. They just kind of sitting around jamming and singing, and he said, "You know, we could probably fill in the spot if you need to." And I said, "Well, okay." Now, you realize this, you know, we do country music. And he said, "Well, this is country. The country happens to be Jamaica." But for something completely different, and I guarantee you, you are going to enjoy it. Chase Akins, Joey Becerra, Brady Becerra.
Big round of applause for the band. They're doing a great job.
Thank you. patient, getting in to get my turn to win some or learn some, but I won't hesitate no more, no more. Here can I wait? I'm yours. Yeah. Yeah. Open up your mind and see like me. Open up your plans and dream you're free. Look into your heart and you'll find the love. Hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm sure there's no need to complicate. Our time is short. This is our fate. I'm yours.
Checking my tongue in the mirror and bending over backwards just to try to see it clearer. Breath bombed up the glass. So much of a mix and I laugh. I guess what I'll be saying is there ain't no better reason to print anything.
Sorry.
And season, it's what I aim to do.
Our plans are our virtue, but I won't hesitate. Cannot wait. I'm yours.
Open up your mind and see it like me. Open up your plans and dream your dream. Look into your heart and you'll find the sky is yours.
But I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait.
I think the sound of the neck is pretty cool, Williams.
Ow!
How about another big hand for them? That one is really cool. As a matter of fact, that's the first time Brandy Gasset has ever performed on stage. He wouldn't even come out under the porch till he was like 9 years old. This next lady, I love to hear her sing. I watched her sing a long time. I've heard her sing. She is not only a great singer, but she is a decent human being. She really, really is. How about a big hand for Miss Angie Joyner?
Thank you. It's so good to be here and see all my family and friends. When I decided to, of course, it's always a joke because they're going to say when I come up with a song, they're going to say, oh, she's going to change her mind. And I couldn't come up with one, but this song has been, y'all can tell me later how long ago it's come out, but when it came out, I have yet to sing it without crying at some point through the song. And I just sat down and I said, I'm going to do this song. I have got to do this song. And anyway, I made it through it last night, and I think I can do it tonight. And I'm going to dedicate it to the woman that lives in the house that built me. And Mom, too. And
know they say you can't go home again. I just had to come back one last time. Ma'am, I know you don't know me from Adam, but these handprints on the front steps are mine. Up those stairs, in that little back bedroom, is where I did my homework and I learned to play guitar. And I bet you didn't know, under that live oak, my favorite dog is buried in the yard. I'm gonna do it. I thought if I could touch this place or feel it, this brokenness inside me might start healing. Out here it's like I'm someone else. I thought that maybe I could find myself. If I could just come in, I swear I'll leave. Won't take nothing but a memory from the house that built me. Mama cut out pictures of houses for years, from Better Home and Garden magazine. Plans were drawn in concrete, poured and nail by nail and board by board. Daddy gave life to Mama's dream. I thought if I could touch this place or feel it, this brokenness inside me might start healing. Out here it's like I'm someone else. I thought that maybe I could find myself. If I could just come in, I swear I'll leave. Won't take nothing but a memory from the house that built me. But a memory from the house that built me.
Thank you.
Thank you, Johnny. And you're going to know the truth. Whenever I say I have that effect on a lot of people, they start crying as well. Oh boy, for something completely different. The tallest man on stage, the tallest man on nearly any stage. This man was born at an early age, raised on a mayonnaise farm. He's tuning right now. And the reason he tunes is because he cares. Here in just a minute, he's gonna bust loose and do a song that he's dedicating to his wife, Angie, I think. This is a very special song. Isn't that right, Barry? How about a big hand for the one and the only Mr. Barry Joyner?
This is her favorite song from her favorite artist. I did.
people who buy the bash tickets are fine Christian people, because I know the only reason they buy the ticket is to help the college. They're good-hearted people. They do not come to watch the crazy people on the stage, is what I have figured out. And they don't travel all those miles, and they spend their hard-earned $20 to watch the crazy people on the stage, and they sure don't come to watch that band.
Yeah, that band, they're a bunch of heathens.
That's right. And but I'm telling you, another good part about the Barnyard Bash is the women for Crowley's Ridge College. Oh, they're the sweetest, best women. They work so hard. There's just a few of them, but they put on these programs and everything. But, you know, they go by WCRC, which is Women for Crowley's Ridge College. For years, I thought WCRC meant worried about colon rectal cancer. Who knew?
Well, I'm worried about that.
Anyway, the WCRC at that Barnyard Bash had a country store, and they got the best stuff for sale. I'm going to show you what I bought. I bought a whole bunch of these pretzel sticks, got little ribbons on them. I'm going to put them in the Easter baskets. And they also had a spoon with lots of chocolate. And you stir that in your hot coffee or hot chocolate. Oh, it makes it so delicious. I'm so glad I got those. I hope that you keep making that so they can keep selling those. I hate to tell you this, but you've got a dead animal stuck right on your face.
Well, I can take a lot of your jokes, but that's kind of sensitive. I've been trying real hard to grow a beard.
It just ain't been growing very fast, but I was telling Grandpa about it the other day. He said, I got just the stuff for that. He said, I'll come by your house this afternoon. He said, oh, by the way, do you want it in cube size like marshmallows, or do you want it in paste? I said, well, how much is the marshmallows? He said, it's $1 a pound. I said, well, what's the paste cost? He said, it's 50 cents a pound. I said, I want the paste. So he said, okay. He brought this by, and he gave it to me, and he said, now you stick this in the microwave for 2 minutes. And then after 2 minutes, you put it on your beard. So I stick this thing in the microwave for 2 minutes, and then I opened it up, and it had an aroma that I recognized, but I just couldn't place. But anyway, I got me a handful in both hands, and I put it on my face, and I was looking in the mirror, rubbing it in good, and all of a sudden, this steam just kind of rises from my beard. So I called Grandpa up, and I said, Grandpa, what this thing's making my face steam? He said, well, that shows you it's working. He says, that stuff will make your beard grow just like fertilizer does grass. So I rubbed it all in there, got it all in there good, and it was working pretty good. And then it started grinding on me, and it started itching and scratching, and it hit my beard, and I'd get brushed and brush it out, and it hit my mouth. And after I got it all out of there, then it finally worked. And looking at my beard, it's growing pretty good, so I guess he knows what he's talking about.
Well, what is it called?
Well, he's got it on here. It says Fresh Manure.
Junior, that is fresh manure.
I gave him 50 cents for this painting. I could have got my own free.
Just go take a bath and shave all that off and just start over.
Shave.
It's gross.
Lulu, I'm growing this beard for a reason. You know they're celebrating 50 years out there at Crowley's Ridge College.
Yeah, I know that. I heard that Crowley's Ridge College is 50 years old. Let's see, this is 2014, so it must have began back in 1964, right? Well, 1964, I was just a babe in arms.
Lulu, you might at some point have been young, but you ain't never been a baby. You know, I was kind of surprised that it's not a little older than that. They got buildings out there. I know it was 80 years old.
That secretary out there at the front desk, out there at the office, she's at least 100 years old. One thing that probably makes her look so old is that she joined the Suntan Olympics.
Suntan Olympics.
Mm-hmm, Suntan Olympics. She's pretty good at it. She got a bronze.
Well, I stopped by out there and I got one of these here calendars. It's got Crowley's Ridge College, 50 years of blessing students. And see, that's why I grew the beard. Now, when I go out there, I want to have a nice, long, flowing beard so I don't look extinguished.
Yeah, you look extinguished, all right. You know, you guys are lucky. You can just let your hair grow on your face. You know, us women can't do that. You know how long we women stand in front of the mirror and those hairs out with plucking them out? Man, it hurts. I don't know what it is, you know. I used to have a lot of hair on my legs, and after a certain age, you know, it just kind of goes in on your legs and comes out up here. I don't know what it is.
Lulu, that's what you call too much HI. That's too much hairy information.
It's just a cruel thing. You know, when you get a certain age and your eyesight starts to go and you have to get these readers and you can't see the hair to pluck it out. You have to get the magnifying mirror and that's right there.
How do we get on this subject? Lulu, I'm not interested in your hairy problems. But speaking of hair, I found a gray hair in my food, which I'm kind of used to. That doesn't really bother me. But this time, I found a gray hair in the food at the potluck, and it was Blue Dean's pie.
Oh, that poor old thing. She can't see much anymore, you know. So one good thing about her, Blue Dean sings with the senior bees. She's pretty good. She's got quite a large repertoire.
Yeah, with them big flowery dresses she wears, she's got a large repertoire. But I heard she sang out there at Sunshine Land the other day. She got finished singing all her songs and she said, "Well, I hope y'all do better." And when she's walking out the door, all the people at Sunshine Manor says, "We hope you do too."
I'm not gonna talk bad about Lou Dean now. She's a really good friend of mine. She's really what I call my BFF.
BFF.
Mm-hmm.
BFF. You mean she's a bowl of fattening food?
No, BFF, that means a best friends forever. You know, Lou Dean, she's got the same whisker problem as I've got. She has plucked those whiskers out every
time. How did we get on that subject again?
Well, I guess it's because we're talking about the 50th anniversary and I want to keep my grooming up today because I want to go to that 50th anniversary. You know, I just want to look good, and, you know, I might see an old boyfriend or something.
Well, I hear they're going to have a pretty big shindig out there. And they invited us because we're aluminuses, which means we went to school out there.
That's right.
You know, I wonder if they want to meet a barbecue coon.
Oh, that'd be good. Barbecue coon with velveta cheese and sauce, you know. I just almost panicked the other day on the radio. They said that there was going to be a shortage of velveta. I nearly
can't. Good. Maybe I might get regular again.
You know what? I just bet that Crowley's Ridge College is going to have this big 50th anniversary. I bet you they're going to have a homecoming queen. And you know what? If they have a homecoming queen and it's the 50th anniversary, that means the homecoming queen would be about 50. That means I might could be homecoming queen. I've always wanted to be a homecoming queen.
Lulu, you being a homecoming queen is about like hanging a chandelier in a haunted house. One thing about a reunion, you know, you might meet some of them old boyfriends you're talking about. You remember old Burl and Estelle?
Oh, yeah.
Well, Burl and Estelle, of course, he was a widower and she was a widow, and they met at one of them reunions.
I heard that they were going to renew their vows. They vowed not to kill each other. Go ahead, sir.
Was they going to get married? Yeah, they was going to get married. But anyway, they met, and they started talking about old times, and then all of a sudden they were just giggling and laughing like kids. And then all of a sudden there was just some sparking going on. And before the end of the night, old Burl just said, "Why don't you just marry me?" And she thought about it for about 6 seconds, and she says, "Well, I think I will." And he was just so happy she was too, and he went to his house, and she went to hers, and he went to bed, and he woke up about 3 o'clock that morning, sat straight up, and he said, "I can't remember what she said." And he worried the whole night. And he finally got up the next morning, and he called her, and he said, I can't remember if you said yes, you could marry me, or I can't remember if you said no." And she said, "Oh, you silly man. Of course I'll marry you. And I'm so glad you called, because I couldn't remember who asked me. You still got that fruit?
I guess. I had a bad case of whatever it was. I went to the doctor and I was so aggravated. I've been to him 3 times and I told him how sick I was. He wouldn't do a whole lot. He said, flu? And I said, no, I drove here. What difference does that make?
Well, I'm glad you guys signed up for Obamacare, even if you did stay on the phone for 4 days. We got our mail in today.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Says the Obamacare website. Says with Obamacare, you can get a coupon.
Oh, yeah?
And this coupon, you get leeches for 50% off. And it, you know, that Obamacare is going to be a lot like eBay. You know, old Wilbur, he's got a $15 bid on a gallbladder operation. You guys had a gallbladder operation? And then on these ambulance rides, you can get 2 packages there. You can get one package, it's got 4 ambulance rides a year.
Yeah.
Or you can get another package, it's got 8 ambulance rides a year.
Yeah.
If you get the one that's got 8 ambulance rides a year, you get a free meal with it, which don't sound bad.
That's not bad.
It says here that the free meal is an IV line in your arm hooked to an entire Golden Corral buffet.
There you go.
And then it says order today.
I'm just tired of it. I'm just gonna forget about that medical stuff. I'm gonna let the good people down at the Hobby Lobby take care of all that stuff. You know, they stay closed on Sundays and they're good people. I'm just gonna let them take care of it. You know, I wondered how church was on Sunday. I was sick and I hated I missed it.
Well, we got a special announcement in the bulletin, and I'll just read it to you. Let's see.
Okay.
Special announcement. Here we go. Says here, Adam Belch, who is a missionary from Africa, will talk about his work in Africa this coming Sunday. Now listen to this real close.
Okay.
Please come and hear Adam Belch all the way from Africa.
I really hope I can go this Sunday because I just miss being there and I love seeing all the little children, you know. You know what? My best friend has a grandbaby and it was the cutest thing he said. He said, Daddy, are there zombies in heaven?
Zombies?
I don't know. That's what his daddy said. He said, Son, why do you think there's zombies in heaven? And he said, Blue skies and rainbows and zombies from heaven. That's the cutest thing. That's a true story, too. How'd that preacher do on Sunday?
I had no preacher. I'm not too sure about the boy. You know, he was doing a sermon and he was talking about the distance between Dan and Beersheba. Which doesn't make a lot of sense to me. I mean, if he wants to know the difference between 2 towns, he ought to name the town still the people live in it.
Well,
it just didn't make sense to me. Well, you know, Lulu, I've been thinking about this calendar thing here, and you ought to send in one of your good recipes for this 50th celebration.
Yeah.
You know, a good recipe for, it might get you to be the homecoming queen.
Oh, well.
It couldn't hurt.
Yeah.
And I love ice cream, and I love root beer. You could have a homecoming float.
Well, that's a good idea, but you know, Junior, you just got to start eating healthier. You can't just eat ice cream and sodas and candy bars all the time. You need to eat healthier. How about a corn dog? Well, I had already thought about a homecoming recipe, and you're right. That might improve my chances to be homecoming queen, and I've already thought about it. I'm going to make a Pioneer whoopie pie. That will be perfect because see that big old word on there, Pioneer? That is the mascot for Perlis Ridge College, the Pioneer. So I'll make a Pioneer whoopie pie. I'll probably win.
A Pioneer whoopie pie?
Yeah.
What is that?
Well, it's kind of a moon pie with just a little more whoopie. Yeah. Well, what you do is you take your moon pie and you dip it down into the corn dog batter. And then you deep fat fry it. And then when it comes out of that hot grease, you put a whole cup of powdered sugar on it. But I was trying to think of how I could do it a little more healthy. If we had sliced sugar strawberries. I could stick that in the strawberries, and that'd make it a little healthier.
Well, that makes it sound kind of like yogurt with the fruit on the bottom of it. Yeah. And a deep fried moon pie. That sure sounds good. Did you know that these things make me kind of gritted? I hate reunions. You know, every time you go to a reunion, see all the old folks that you've seen when you was a kid, you look at them and they're fat, they're bald, and they're ugly, and they ain't got no teeth, and then when they look at you, they don't even recognize you.
Well, I thought about that, and I dug around in the attic, and I found my dress that I wore back in 1972. I'm going to try it on to see if it still fits. It took me a while to get a hold of it and dig around up there, but I think I finally found it. Let's see.
Do you really think that you can wear a dress that you wore 42 years ago?
Oh, well, let's see. Let me look right here. I think if I wore it to the anniversary party and people saw me in the same dress, they'd recognize me. Yeah, it still looks good. That looks real good. Yeah. Maybe I should try it on and see if it fits, you think? Oh, something's going on here. Okay, well, I'm gonna have to sit down and put my feet in it. See if I can step into it, you know, that's how I used to just slide up. Just slide up real easy. It was just back in 1972 when I wore this. I'm not that much bigger. Jim, you need to help me do this.
What?
You need to help me do this.
What did I pull?
Well, you pull right back there and I'm going to pull up here. Okay, now, listen. On three. One.
Can I look?
Two. Three. You're not pulling, Junior. You pull.
Yes, I am.
Wait. Let's rest in here. Okay, on three. You ready? One, two, three. You know, I never was no skinny girl.
No.
I never was no skinny girl. I figure I was around 32, 34 inches. I ain't that much bigger.
Like they say in Gone with the Wind, you ain't never gonna see 32 again. Maybe you need to get one of them girdles.
I ain't wearing a girdle in 40 years and I ain't gonna start now.
Well, that makes sense. Them 18-hour girdles on you wear out in about 2 hours.
Okay. As you well know, though, once you let it all hang out, it's no stepping it back in until. Okay. We're gonna get this on. We're gonna get this dress on.
That's what you think.
Are you ready?
By the motto, blessed are the flexible, for they shall be bent out of shape. This is not the song that we rehearsed, but someone requested it. I don't know who it was. Who was it?
Charlie Brock.
For you, Charlie Brock.
One, two, three.
Twister Alley is kind of working on getting back together again, so we'll probably see them again soon on a stage somewhere close by. But this is the gal that was the lead singer for them. How about a big hand for Miss Shelley Morris?
Try to sleep, but sleep.
Last Friday until tonight,
I don't know if he's out with Loretta Lynn or if it is a family vacation or what it was, but he said, I'm sorry, I'm just not going to be able to be there. I hope to be back next year. We got a fella, if you hadn't heard him play yet, you know he's got more licks than a herd of puppies. And he does something that is pretty amazing. If you've not ever seen it, you need to see this. And what I want to do here, and let me say this before I go into that. I think you've met everybody on the stage except for Kevin King, who is a drummer, and he'll be back in a bit, but give him a hand. And then the guy who has the hardest job in the house, who happens to be my son, Scott Cremines, who's sitting back on the bleachers running sound with an iPad back there. And let me tell you, that is a hard job. Because if you've never been up here and been back there and been all around the room, it is hard to get it right for everybody. And he does the best he can, and he does a good job. Now, back to the moment at hand. Ken is a very talented individual. He is going to, we're going to gather up, how many you want? Just tell me when you've had enough. What I want you to do, and I've already got the first one of these, I'll tell you how this works. Larry King has already requested that he play Music Box Dancer. Okay? Write that one down. You got a song that you would like to hear. What's the song you like to hear? Last Date. Why am I not surprised? You got a song you like? Free Bird. Oh, let's think here. Who's got one? Where? What'd you say? Canadian Sunset? Canadian Sunset. Okay. I beg your pardon? Spanish Eyes. We're going multicultural and international here. Spanish Eyes. Gina Colburn. Yes, ma'am. Great Balls of Fire. And don't forget my favorite. It's been lonely on the saddle since my horse died. Anybody else? What else we got? Anybody else got a request? Mark. Okay, something gospel. There's something gospel in there. He's got several gospel medleys that he does down at the Roundup. Yes. You did what to who win? Unchained Melody? Unchained Melody. Running Bear? Running Bear? Ring of Fire. Fire. Ring of Fire. You know Arkansas Twist. It sounds like every other song, it sounds just like that. It really does. One more.
Heart and Soul.
Who?
Heart and Soul.
Heart and Soul. I know he knows that one. Now, I heard somebody mentioning my name over here. The Entertainer. Have you got all you want, or you want another one? All right, ladies and gentlemen, prepare to be amazed. How about a big hand for Mr. Ken Longley? Thank you.
afloat.
Afloat? Lulu's too heavy to float on anything. This here truck is the perfect thing for the parade. Since the roof rusted off, I mean, we got a truck convertible. It's perfect.
Well, I don't know where they're at. Lulu is always late.
They're always late.
Lulu, I broke a tooth on your suit today.
Oh, well, Junior, I don't think
are old, you are. I just ran out of time getting ready. At my age, it takes twice as long to get half as good looking.
Well, I think she meant that you're getting kind of bald, too.
Yeah.
Well, now, some of us choose to be bald. Some of us choose to be ugly. By the way, Grandpa, I got some of that stuff in for hair growing.
Yeah.
Yeah, you put it on your hands like this, and then you rub them hands together, and then you tap it on the bald spot like that.
Does it work?
Well, I ain't got any hair growing on my head yet, but I have to shave my fingers twice a day.
Well, Junior, we won't say you're bald, but I think you are in follicle regression.
Yeah.
Hey, I got something that'll help out with that.
What's that?
Well, look.
What
I got you.
Oh,
a wig? No,
I ain't
wearing
no
wig. I tell a raccoon to
look towards
me.
No, I ain't wearing no wig.
There ain't no way.
Yeah, I think you look younger.
No
way. Yeah, try them on.
No way.
Wait a minute. Let me tell you this. I went all the way to Memphis, and I picked these up at Raceland.
Raceland? Oh, that's different.
I feel a little better.
I feel different.
I feel like, you know, with hair, I feel like a different man.
Me too.
You know what, man? I can remember when I had hair, people used to tell me I used to look a lot like Elvis.
Elvis?
Elvis. Thank you.
Thank you, Bill.
Thank you very much.
Uh-oh. My legs are shaking. My Elvis is showing. You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
Yeah.
Why do I want this itching is all about? I cleaned out my truck since my old dog Blue was in it.
What's that big bug on your arm?
Well, looky here. I think these bugs come from the Olympics.
Oh, man, them Sochi bugs are the worst.
Well, one of them just did a double loose triple cow salad on my arm.
Well, I can't believe this. You know, we got all dressed up to go to this CRC anniversary party, and here we are in the middle of an ant farm. That's a trade.
Well, I hate to tell you this, but it's time for the parade, and we ain't gonna make it.
It's time for homecoming party?
Yep.
Oh, no. It's my only chance to be homecoming queen. I'm gonna miss it.
Well, I was gonna be queen anyway, but anyway, if you listen real carefully, listen. You hear that announcer over there at CRC campus?
And due to a mechanical voting error, the homecoming queen is Junior!
Junior! Goodness!
Junior!
That is terrible. Junior, that's the most disgusting thing I ever heard.
Does this mean I gotta wear a girdle?
One thing you gotta do, if you're gonna be homecoming queen, it's the most disgusting thing is to be a queen and have chin whiskers. You gotta pluck them and pluck those babies out.
Yeah, we still got a tribute song. We sing that, ain't no Jim was homecoming queen.
Yeah.
Hail
to thee, O Junior, Junior, honest things we've seen.
Folks, the funniest thing that happened in that whole deal was what we were seeing. How about another big hand for the comedians who worked so hard to make y'all laugh, makes us laugh. We hear something every year, we wonder, why did they say that? These next folks, you know, I put this on the program as Dixie Hicks, because years gone by, we had some girls, Angie Joyner and Karen, the Karen Pillow, and who's that other girl singing over here? Where is that? Where is she at? Angie and Karen and Christy Cup, yeah. Boy, and I owe Gary Cup a big favor. He went and got me some batteries a while ago. Mine were about to run down. I was getting really tired. But at any rate, they used to sing together some, and they called themselves the Dixie Hicks. Karen moved away and came back, and I asked him if they'd sing again, and they got a little surprise. It's not just the Hicks, but it's the Dixie Hicks and their chicks. How about a big hand for these folks?
There's a wreck up.
poker on Saturday night, church on Sunday morning. We in line, I get the poker. We will go fishing in the coffee shop.
Down in London,
poker on Saturday night, church on Sunday morning.
Bye.
in a northern town.
Hey, mama, mama.
Picks and shakes.
I lost my mic
stand. Oh, it's way up yonder. We just got about a couple of more songs. We are glad that you've hung with us. You won't be disappointed that you waited this long to hear these last two folks. This gal, I've known her dad for since Moses came down from Sinai. He and my wife and my younger brother went to school together. And so we've known each other for a long, long time, but I didn't know until about 3 years ago or so that she was a singer, and she's a good singer. And she's going to do a song that I know you're all going to love. How about a big hand for Miss Abby Whitley? Homer and Mary Jane Kennan's 66th wedding anniversary. Holy cow, can you imagine that? And never had a fight. Congratulations to y'all. This next brother we got coming up, he's gonna sing this song, and I'm gonna ask him to sing one on the way out, by the way, as y'all are getting ready to go. The very, very popular song he does for us. He sings at the Roundup on Saturday nights. A good friend of mine. He's another one of those people that's a decent human being. How about a big hand for Mr. Bob Colburn?
Thank you. I'm really honored to be here. We're glad you're here. If you wasn't here, you'd be somewhere else.
I would be. Gary's like Yogi Berra. He's always got something about nothing to say. I remember waking in the morning to the sound of the rooster's crow. Mama cooking in the kitchen. Arthur Godfrey on the radio. Me and Dad were just like strangers. Never did see eye to eye. Came to blows one Sunday morning. So I packed my bags and I said goodbye. When you leave that way, you can never go back. Train won't roll on a torn up track. Sometimes I wish I'd never gone. Oh, no. When you leave that way, you can never go home. So I met a girl in Knoxville. Oh, we set our wedding day. I left her standing at the altar with a baby on the way. When you leave that way, you can never go back. Train won't roll on a torn up track. Sometimes I wish I'd never owned. Oh, no. When you leave that way, you can never go home. Man to leave me alone. When he came to read my rights, he said, son, when you leave this way, you can never come back. A soul won't roll on a torn up track. All through eternity you'll roam alone. When you leave this way, you can never come home. All through eternity, you'll roam alone. When you leave this way, you can never come home.
Mr. Bob Colburn, thank you. Folks, we're just about to wrap this thing up. How about a great big hand for the WCRC folks, all the ladies that work so hard to put this thing together. Bill Cockburn and Lance Johns, who worked so hard to get everything set up, man, they work hard. Barry Joyner, Steve Goins, Kevin King, Ken Watney, Scott Kameen back there on sound. A big hand for all of those guys. Very important note, and I'm certain every one of you will remember this. Next year, CRC is hosting a regional NCCAA basketball tournament about this time. So what's going to happen, the plan as it stands right now, the Barnyard Bash will be March the 27th, the last Friday night in March. Now, if there's a change in that, we will be sure to let you know. But folks, we're glad you came out tonight. Hope you had a good time. And remember, if you're driving, make sure you got a car.
Yeah. she put it in his hand. Then she giggled and she wiggled and she said, hey, hey, I'm getting ready for my wedding day. But old man's drink. Said goodbye for you.